Council. My name is James Powell. I'm in solidarity, standing in solidarity today with the groups representing the alcohol situation. The visionaries on the board that's come through the community council. Very respectful. Just on the way up here, we are the people that have helped build this city in the last few years. So in the way where it's past, you can see today where it's present, but we're also its future. So I'd like to address the council regarding the proposed amendments to our rent control ordinance. I'm very disappointed and concerned that yet another attempt to weaken the ordinance appears before the council. Not only that, but the subtle manner in which it was introduced again raises serious questions regarding the process of how significant public policy is affected in New York. The proposed changes are nothing less than an extremely generous gift to landlords at the direct expense of the lower tenants. All three clauses in the proposal result in a return on investment of 30%, according to Matt Shapiro, president of the New Jersey Tenants Association, who actually was probably the vote of the draft 2014 model. In addition, the ordinance currently on the books already generously eases the burden of substantial rehabilitation undertaken by landlords. Furthermore, such language practically begs for bad behavior by landlords, as we've seen today in our neighbor cities, New Jersey City. Such a huge bonus only incentivizes harassment and negligence in the pursuit of such legalized windfalls. In essence, this proposal is backdoor vacancy decontrol.
Yes.
Vacancy decontrol eliminates housing and decreases affordability across all economic strata. Again, quoting Matt Shapiro, rent control is supposed to maintain affordability, not destroy it. There is no good reason for these changes to the law of the city of New York. Lastly, the surreptitious manner in which the proposal was introduced raises serious questions about the integrity of the process. There was no tenant notification or even involvement regarding the strategy of drafting. I didn't hear our legislator without a sponsor, even though it came from the council through communications. Lastly, and chillingly to me, its title, and the title included, incorporated a new procedure for calculating the maximum rent increase. But it does very, very much more than that. It's a major public policy change which harms all of the city, 75% of New York citizens who rent.
Yeah.
By the way, even the thing itself was misspelled with procedure, so at the very least, you may ask for some citizen involvement to correct the spelling. So to county capacity, I'd like to ask the council at some point to answer which person, council person or people, are responsible for putting this amendment on the legislature.
Yeah.
Which council person or people drafted the text? How were these rent control exemptions arrived at? By what logic is a 10% increase for a 4-month rent fix-up considered good policy? How will staging renovations by landlords in order to gain the system to an even greater return on investment be preventable? And what person or persons brought the idea of lowering the standards to the council in the first place? The current ordinance was negotiated by all stakeholders in a rigorous process. It was overwhelmingly adopted by the council. It was an attack by the landlords and found to be good law by the Superior Court. The current ordinance is good law.
Yes.
The proposed rollback is a waste of the city's time and money. I request that the council withdraw this item from the agenda or alternatively to table.
Rent your power. We need homes for all. Homes